Sarah and Jeff, here you are. Your wedding day has finally arrived.
What would I do without your smart mouth? Drawing me in and you kicking me out. You got my head spinning, no kidding, I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I'm on your magical mystery ride, and I'm so dizzy, don't know what hit me, but I'll be alright. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing fine. You're crazy and I'm out of my mind, 'cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me, I give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning, even when I lose, I'm winning. 'Cause I give you all of me, and you give me all of you. How many times do I have to tell you? Even when you're crying, you're beautiful too. The world is beating you down. I'm around through every mood. You're my downfall, you're my muse, my worst distraction, my rhythm and blues. I can't stop singing, it's ringing in my head for you. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing fine. You're crazy and I'm out of my mind, 'cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me, I'll give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning, even when I lose, I'm winning.
'Cause maybe I give seated. Love comes from God. Everyone who truly loves is a child of God. Through this service of matrimony, let us worship God. Dearly beloved, we are gathered together in the sight of God to witness the marriage of Sarah and Jeff, and trust each other and to face all of life together. It is designed to unite two sympathies and hopes into one, and it rests upon the mutual confidence and devotion of husband and wife. With our love and our prayers, we support Jeff and Sarah as they now freely enter into this happy and holy union. Let us pray. Gracious God, always faithful in your love for us, we rejoice in your presence. You create love. You unite us in one human family. You offer your word and lead us in light. Bless us all today as we witness the gifts of your grace in the lives of Sarah and Jeff. Open your arms and embrace us all in love that knows no end. Amen. Sarah and Jeff, here you are. Your wedding day has finally arrived. It seems to me that in one sense, you have reached this destination after months of investing so much time and energy and planning your wedding. But in reality, your ride together has just begun. And I promise you, it's going to be a wonderful adventure. When a couple approaches me about plans to get married, I encourage them to take what is called a pre-marriage awareness inventory. This survey consists of a series of more than 100 questions that cover a wide range of topics that should be considered before entering a marriage. The couple is asked to respond to these questions separately, and then we gather together to review and compare the answers. I have to say that I wish that the pastor that married me back in the late 1980s had insisted that my future husband and I complete such a questionnaire. Even though I'm pretty sure it wouldn't have prevented our marriage, it would have helped us both be more clear-eyed about what we were getting into. Neither Sarah nor Jeff needs to worry about that. Their answers consistently mirrored each other. It is obvious that you both know each other very well, are fully aware of what is needed to make a successful marriage, share the same values, and are completely committed to making this union work. Most striking of all is how they both are utterly and hopelessly devoted to their children. After all, how many newlyweds decide to invite their children to join them on their honeymoon? But this is important because, as we all know, this marriage is not just joining two people, but two families. As I've said many times, Jeff, you are the best thing to happen to Sarah. And although I haven't known Jeff for as long as I've known Sarah, I believe Sarah is the best thing that has happened to Jeff. You not only bring out the best in each other, but you complement the other beautifully. As long as you maintain your sense of humor, always allow the free flow of communication, face any challenges together, and let your Christian faith guide you, you will have a long and a very happy marriage. It is a picture-perfect day to begin your life as husband and wife. Wishing you enough happiness to make you sweet, enough trials to make you strong, enough sorrow to keep you human, and enough hope to make you happy. Amen. Jeff and Sarah, in the presence of God, your family, and friends, I ask you to affirm your willingness to enter into this covenant of marriage and to share all the joys and sorrows of this new relationship, whatever the future may hold. Jeff, will you have Sarah to be your wife? And will you love her faithfully as long as you both shall live? If so, please say, I will.
I will.
And Sarah, will you have Jeff to be your husband? And will you love him faithfully as long as you both shall live? If so, please say, I will.
I will.
Jeff and Sarah, please repeat after me your vows to one another that you have come to offer before God and those assembled. Jeff, repeat after me. I Jeff. Wait till I finish a couple of words. I, Jeffrey Correa. Take you, Sarah Gilmore. To be my lawfully wedded wife.
Wedded wife.
My constant friend. My faithful partner. And my love.
My love.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
It's okay. In the presence of God, our family and friends, I offer you my solemn vow.
I will offer my solemn vow
to be your faithful partner,
in
sickness and in health.
Sickness and health.
Just look at me. In good times and in bad.
Good times and bad.
And in joy as well as sorrow.
Joy as well as sorrow.
I promise to love you. Unconditionally. To support you in your goals. To honor and respect you.
And respect you.
And to cherish you.
Cherish.
for as long as we both shall live. Now, Sarah. I, Sarah Gilmore. Take you, Jeff Carrero. To be my lawfully wedded husband. My constant friend. My faithful partner. And my love from this day forward.
In the presence of God.
Our family and friends.
I offer you my solemn vow.
To be your faithful partner.
In sickness and in health.
In good times and in bad.
And enjoy as well as sorrow.
I promise to love you unconditionally. To support you in your goals. To honor and respect you. And to cherish you as long as we both shall live. So Jeff and Sarah, what will you share to symbolize your love?
Rings.
So Nate, the ring bearer, come on up, buddy. If you can stand beside me for a minute, that'd be great. By these rings of covenant promise, gracious God, remind Jeff and Sarah of your encircling love and unending faithfulness, that in all their life together they may know joy and peace in one another. Jeff, please take Sarah's left hand, and as you place the ring on her finger, repeat after me. Sarah, I give you this ring. As a sign of my love and faithfulness. Sarah, will you take Jeff's left hand, and as you place the ring on his finger, repeat after me. Jeff, I give you this ring as a sign of my love and my faithfulness.
Jeff, I give you this ring as a sign of my love and my faithfulness.
Sarah and Jeff, today you are making a lifelong commitment to share the rest of your lives with each other and to honor your children as well. So I would ask you to step down and all gather. Sarah and Jeff and their children to gather around this unity stand. All right. Your family relationship is symbolized through the pouring of these individual containers of sand, one representing each one of you, all that you were, all that you are, and all that you ever will be. There are children who will share in this marriage. The gathering of this new family will have a deep influence upon them. We realize that in order for the home to be a happy one, it is essential that there be love and understanding between the children and the adults being married. As you each hold your sand, the separate containers of sand represent your lives to this moment, individual and unique. As you now combine your sands together, your lives also join together as one family. You may now individually pour the contents of your separate containers into one container, symbolizing the uniting of not only the bride and groom, but also the inclusion of their children, Gianna, Ayana, and Nick, into one family. Never be separated and poured again into the individual containers, so will your marriage and your family. God has joined together, let no one separate. Sarah and Jeff, you have given yourselves to each other in sacred and joyous covenant. Be merciful in all your ways, kind in heart and humble in mind. Accept life and be most patient with one another. Forgive as freely as God has forgiven you. And above everything else, be truly loving. Let peace rule in your hearts and never forget to be grateful for one another. With the blessing of the church and the affirmation of your friends and your family, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Friends and family, I'm delighted to present to you for the very first time as husband and wife, Sarah and Jeff Correia.
Every time our eyes meet, this feeling inside me is almost more than I can take. Baby, when you touch me, I can feel how much you love me, and it just blows me away. I've never been this close to anyone or anything. I can hear your thoughts, I can see your dreams. I don't know how you do what so in love with you. It just keeps getting better.
For the first time, we're going to introduce Mr. and Mrs.
I want to spend the rest
Sarah
of
and Jeffrey
my
Correia.
Life with you by my side forever and ever. And every little thing that you do, baby, I'm amazed by you. Every place in my heart. Oh, it feels like the first time, every time. I wanna spend the whole night in your eyes. I don't know how you do what you do. I'm so in love with you. It just keeps getting better. You by my